First of all, I like to convey my gratitude towards the organizers who consider me worthy to share this stage. I feel so happy and overwhelmed seeing first and second MBA students doing all these activities, because it was unheard of when I was a student in early 80s. And that shows that the whole generation is progressing. I have been entrusted with the task of talking on robotic PCI, beginning of a new era. Robot, as I think everybody is aware of robot in whichever field robot has entered, it has created a major impact and it has occupied a space, and people have utilized robot to the best of their abilities to deliver. Robot entered medical science in the medical field through surgery. The surgical robot was the first, that is Da Vinci robot. And you know that it has become a standard of care for many procedures. For cath lab and cardiology, interventional cardiology, it was the last entrant, because heart is the only moving structure in the body, and it was difficult to synchronize the artificial intelligence to make sure that the robot works with the moving heart and in small arteries properly. Let me discuss few milestones in interventional cardiology. It started in 1895, more than 100 years ago, when Röntgen, invented the X-rays, and now you know that what is the value, and that has created a tremendous impact. Following that, Werner Forssmann, again in Germany, who did the first unofficial catheterization. The story is, very interesting. He was a urology resident, and he thought that if I introduce directly the antibiotic inside the heart, there are good chances that patient can recover fast. So he himself did a cut down of his own vein and injected the contrast and took the pictures, taking one of the nurses in confidence. And then he showed that picture in the department, and he was rewarded by termination of his residency. And that is way back in 1929, and when first official catheterization done in US in 1942 and 55, when Nobel Prize was considered for Purnam and Richard, one of the members of the Nobel Prize committee, remembered him. So that Nobel Prize was shared between three of them. First pacemaker, first open heart surgery, Walter Lilley, Mason Stones, again, first coronary angiography, and that was also by accident and not by design. He was doing aortic root angio, and accidentally the catheter entered the coronary circulation and injected, and that is how the coronary was profiled, and that is how the first coronary angiogram was done. And Judkins introduced the easier way through the groin. And then different inventions, including the heart transplant, and first angioplasty was done by Andreas Gerzig. All this first in human has its own importance, because any first in human procedure goes through, multiple phases of criticism, comments, and lot of stone throwing, and then it evolves. And that is why there is importance. First coronary stenting was done by Ulrich Ziegler. Again, you see most of them were Europeans and few of them were American or South African or South American. And for the first aortic valve was done by Alan Cribier, again a close friend. And for the first time, I was privileged to do something first in human in the world, that is distant telerobotic stenting. Sitting away from one place, that was by design, it was not by accident, for sure. What is robotic PCI? Here, we are using a robotic arm. We are loading everything, in the cassette, which is being added to the robot, my partner, Dr. Sanjay, and here they are fixing everything. And this is how now everything is ready. And you can see I am sitting on the console and playing with these three knobs as if, you know, you may have a feeling that I am doing and playing some video game. And this is exactly what we are doing, millimeter by millimeter, you know, progress of the guide wire, millimeter by millimeter progress of the balloon and stand. And, you know, you can, you know, Rocco has brought significant amount of accuracy and precision of the procedure in our field. And all these hand tremors, these and that, everything, problem happening because of that, are completely eliminated. And this is how the procedure is done. No radiation, no radiation cover, nothing. And you sit comfortably in the console and work, you know, just one foot away, you can see everything so closely. And this is how, this total occlusion, and this is how the artery is open. How it started? The concept actually came in the mind of Professor Rafi Bayer, Israel, Haifa. He thought that the cardiologists are, you know, many of them, they had suffered spine problems, some of them had brain tumors, some of them had cancers. Because of heavy radiation and taking a heavy lead coat all the time from morning to evening. So he thought that I should do something which can bring a little bit of ease to the cardiologists. And that is how he designed the first, he conceptualized the first, you know, robotic arm. But, and then it went to US. And then the second generation robo was developed by Corindus. Second generation robo was more sophisticated. And there were a few centers, some top centers like Mayo Clinic, Columbia Presbyterian had this robot, and the cardiologists were doing those robotic interventions anecdotally. And when I saw this happening first time in Columbia Presbyterian, I made up my mind that I must have this. This was in 2017, month of January, when I was visiting New York. Then after some discussion, I was able to finalize, and the 5th of December was a historic day when we did first robotic PCI outside US. That is in Asia, Europe, Africa, New Zealand, Australia. The first time we installed the robot outside US, and this is how we did several cases on 5th and 6th December, and that is how our program started. And these were the historic moment. The company engineer, you can see here, yes, my partner Dr. Sanjay, we all, you know, did successfully several cases, and we had, you know, a press conference, and we showed them, we narrated them, this happened. Simultaneously, Corindus announced, you know, the news of our center being the global center of excellence after some time. Because by the time when we started robotics, people were in their 70s, 80s, or 90s. And from December 5th, 2017, when we started doing in 1 year time, we did almost 300 robotics, and we became number one center in the world, me and my team. And that is how, you know, we could draw the attention of the whole world in Ahmedabad, particularly at Apex, where we are practicing it very regularly. If you see, you have shown so many live demonstrations in last 1.5 years. We have shown so many cases live in the major conferences, including our own TRICO, India Live, and so many other conferences where we have started teaching our peers and our juniors the way of, you know, working with robotics. And the CEO of the company, Mark Solan, visited Apex Heart Institute in May 2018. And at that point of time, we finalized the first human distant telerobotic PCI site. He was thinking that, you know, we should go to some centers in Colombia or somewhere where, you know, the regulations will not prohibit or come in the way of this procedure. And then we were able to convince him that we will get all the regulatory permissions from the central government, from our local regulatory body, but we want to make it in India itself. And it was not easy. And we decided, you know, the remote stamping site And everybody was thinking that we should have something which has the historical significance, and it should be a very major site of very major importance to the country. And simultaneously, the distance should be minimum 20 miles. So we thought that Akshardham Gandhinagar, which was 32 kilometers away from my place, the site cannot be better than that site. And that is how it was finalized. After that, I had to go to, by design, I had to go to Mayo Clinic, to Rochester Mayo Clinic. All of you know, it is the best center in the world for any medical ailment. And I was one of the primary investigators with Professor Gulati, Professor Lerman, and Professor Sandhu. And we did distant telerobotic stamping in several peaks. The peaks are on the 13th floor, and we are sitting on the second floor, and using the internet bandwidth, we did angioplasties, in several peaks during those 2 weeks. And after finishing that, and after making sure that everything is fine, we decided the D-date, and it was the 5th of December, exactly 1 year after we started our robotic program in 2017. 5th December 2018 was finalized as a D-date for distant telerobotic stenting, and by that time, under our belt, we already had 276 cases that were the highest experience, individual experience in the world, and everybody was excited. And I was a little bit tense also, because if anything goes wrong, it could have very adversely affected the career. This is what I want to tell all young doctors sitting over here, or young doctor to be sitting over here. If you want to do some innovation, there is a major fear of failure. So that has to be eliminated. You have to confront with the failure very gracefully, if at all. And you must understand, like Thomas Alva Edison, after more than 1,000 failures, he was able to invent the electric bulb. And he was asked that, how did you feel, going through the frustration of 1,000 failures? And he told that, I don't think that it was frustration. I found 1,000 different ways of failing. So that was a positive mentality. And the same thing, that is what I, and so there was apprehension. We lined up 5 cases 32 kilometers away, sitting in Akshardham, my team, Dr. Sanjay, my partner, Yash, and Dr. Rajni, and the whole of my team was ready at Apex, and we had a console ready at Akshardham. Why I chose Akshardham? It is a religious place, but let me tell you, they are techno-savvy. The IT team is comparable to none. They are very bright people, and every single hitch they were able to eliminate. Mr. Parimal Natwani, the vice president of Reliance, was kind to provide us Jio internet bandwidth, because we wanted 100 Mbps bandwidth for that. So all those formalities were done. We took the permission from the our IRB, as well as we notified our study to the CRI, and made sure that everything is as per the routine with the ready protocol. We went through the initial rituals over there, and then we started working. And this is me sitting on the console, and you can see in the TV screen in front of me my cath lab with my crew, including Dr. Sanjay, Yash, Dr. Rajni, everybody ready. And this is how we created the setup over there. And one by one, we did 5 real critical lesions sitting over there. And successfully, we were able to do. And this is, a short, 1 minute film, which shows the first case at which we threw it open. The first case was thrown open to the media, which was sitting 100 meters away in the IMAX theater in the Akshardham. And this is how I started, everything ready. You can see the critical block in the main artery. I am just moving the joysticks now and handling the wire and the balloon. And this is how we negotiated everything inside, step by step. And the comfort level was utmost, because I was not worried about any technical hitch. because the people at Amsterdam were so good. I was provided with a proper uninterrupted bandwidth, and we were able to do, and I felt as if I am working and doing this case as if I was sitting at Apex Heart Institute in my own lab, 2 meters away from the patient. That comfort, I experienced. And this is how we fixed the block, you can see. And the procedure was, this is procedure, the procedure is done. And first case was shown directly to the media. And that was again, a bit risky move. But if I don't do this, there will be, criticism that you have already done it, you are showing the recording. And that is the reason why I took that chance and threw it open to the media. These were the 5 cases, you can see the profile, the lesion criticality, and the result. All 5 were successfully done, and these are the data, radiation data. These were the blocks, and this is the block after opening. You can see 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5 cases. And these are the happy moments, in the cath lab, Dr. Sanjay, Dr. Rajni, Yash, who are with me since decades, working with me. And this is the happy moment at Amsterdam with the CEO of Corindus, Mark Toland. There's other doctors who came from US, who shared, Dr. Samir Pancholi, who was with me at Amsterdam. And this was the press conference. First in human was a big thing for India, because in India, at least to the best of my knowledge, this level of first in human work has never been done. And I don't take credit for it, but I personally feel that I was fortunate to have this opportunity to do it. There may be so many who can do that, but God was kind to me. And this was the press coverage happening at that time. And this technology got a widespread publicity across the world, everywhere. So what is the future of distant telerobotic stenting? You must be wondering that we did it. What is the future? Future is this. I am sitting in my cath lab at my institute with a console, and imagine that there are underprivileged areas in this country, everywhere in the world, in US, in Africa, everywhere. In India, if I sit at one place, and if there are 5 cath labs or 8 cath labs in a different field, which will be connected with 5G, which is going to be reality down the line in 6 to 12 months. You can shoot in 4 or 5 different layers if they have robots. So, ultimately, the impact will be mainly on these 2 areas, primary PCI, acute heart attack cases, who take time from coming from underprivileged area to the major centers, or acute stroke. There is a small window period. And if you miss that window period, patient suffers permanent damage. And if you have this technology available, I think we should be able to reduce that morbidity and mortality because of that, and time will show that. Another most important thing is, today, like I am an experienced interventionalist and having more than 100,000 procedures under my belt. And there is some new young guy who comes with experience of 1,000 or 500 cases. But there is some medium experienced guy who has 10, 20,000 cases under the belt. Here, with robotic intervention, the results, the difference between the results of an experienced, medium experience, and a less experience of the new guy will be practically eliminated down the line in few years, because more and more of the artificial intelligence is being loaded, and that can be good for the society, because there will be homogeneity as far as the results are concerned in regular cases, in complicated cases, in the most complicated cases also. Thank you very much for your kind attention.